So, AVATR11, a very sleek, pure electric SUV. Today we'll be driving this in some of the most complex traffic in China with, allegedly, one of the best assistant drive system in China, HUAWEI Inside. I'm Jack, this is Where to Go, and welcome to our Cruise Drive special. So for anyone familiar with Huawei, it is one of the top tech company in China working on ICT, AI, high-tech computer stuff. And for us to get access to their driving system, there are basically two ways. Buy a car where they fully have a say, or a car where they simply lend a hand. Okay, so now we're in the cabin. By the way, I really love this floating interior. I never seen anything like this at this price point. I think it's really good design. So
let's get started with some really simple basic parking missions. Like we can see here on the screen, we're surrounded by the parking lots. Okay, so now we select like this one and we're getting ready. Activate it.
Nailed it.
So this car has a special additional function called Valet parking. It means it memorizes the exact position and parking lot, and it can just drive itself to the point. That, I didn't see that coming, so this is also the first time we use it. Let's try. So according to the official, at first it requires a full recognition of the map and the route. You'll see here it's scanning everything around it. So we circled back at the gate, now we're moving in. As I said, this is the first time, so we better raise for impact. Okay. It's on. It's pretty cautious. Yeah, it is slowed down at the crossroad. Yes! Pretty on spot. Okay, so I have to say, I think this is a pretty long way from the gate to here. I think because this is a mall, I think it's better than I expected. It's really good.
So what do you think? We had a very good adventure underground, and now we're moved to the surface, and this is a sunny day, perfect day for a test drive on highways, like on the urban streets. So to see how it it feels and how it drives with its cruise control. Okay, so let's go. Now we're going to have a thorough experience of HUAWEI Inside on this classic touring route in Chongqing. This is a city built among hills and mountains with a rapid growing popularity worldwide. We'll be driving this car through interchanges, riverside highways, bridges, and mountain roads. All famous sightseeing spots to test its performance. Starting from Huangchao CBD, where we have the highest building in West China, we'll be driving on this Jiangling Riverside Highway, heading straight to the east with the HUAWEI NCA cruise control full on. It's not a long ride before we get to Leeds Metro Station, where the train passes through the building. Not far is what was once the residence of General Stilwell, the chief of staff of the Allied China Theater during World War II. There are even monuments on the Nanshan for all those American volunteer pilots died here. Now we're passing the first crossroad. It chose the right way and made an active overtake and stirred our driver's nerve. This is a light rail immersing to the surface, and it should go underground somewhere. Fascinating. In the jam, the cruise leaves a gap for aggressive drivers, but overall the car is doing fine staying on the tail. Now the road is splitting from two lanes and five. The car tilted a little to the right, and for the first time our wheelman stepped in, going straight. Things got complicated here with more cars because of incoming turning sites, and that truck is seemingly going to stop, and we have to look out for the cars coming from the right. We see AVATR trying to go for that direction, but kind of goes back and forth. And finally stay in line with our push on the throttle. Now this is a case showing its caution on the street. With those taxis standing in the front, AVATR undoubtedly obeys the rules and waits. So we have to step in for a lane change. Now this is one of the landmarks of the city, Hongyadong. In this scenario, our car managed to change lanes for a few times, and it did it quite smoothly, I gotta say. Tell me if you think it's too much. This is a U-turn and the car just asked for takeover. That's because passing such turns take lateral lidars on the back, which is absent on most EVs, including this one. What we have here on the left and front is the Hongyadong and the Chansimen Bridge, where it used to be shantytown and studded buildings 20 years ago. Such significant drop of the hill is exactly what this place is famous for, as you can get to the surface from both the first and the 10th floor. Here, a car in the front made a sudden move, which apparently didn't trigger anything on our AVATR, including automatic brake. Now, this is a bad case, since there didn't seem to be any intrusion, so we had to take over. Now we're on the ramp with cruise control, while uneasily fast. Traffic light spotted. No green light, but the car seems nervous. Probably too much flow on the main road.
So what?
And finally we pedal down to accelerate. Now the cruise is out, we had no idea but to reactivate. Now we're in Jiangbei 3 CBD right after an overtake on the Huanghuayuan Bridge. This place used to be slums, but now it's home to many high-value companies, including this AVATR's parent company, Chang'an. Now we're facing a four-lane crossroad, which is a tricky one even for many local drivers. But AVATR nailed it without much thinking. That's a big thumb. 是不是? Here, we're merging into the main road, but suddenly the car made a boat move, trying to combat the bus and squeeze in, leaving us no choice but to take over on a safety. Ramping into Panlong Interchange. We just changed lanes twice to dodge collisions. Now this could be one of the most complex interchanges on the planet, so it's fair to bomb into one or two vehicles who lost their way. Now we're about to get into the inner ring highway. Let's see how it goes. Oh, that was an unnecessary move over a full line. Safety take over. There is a construction up front, which the crews dodged clean, but it still jumped out due to the cones. That might be one of the leader's shortcomings, but we don't know if Tesla and its FSD could cover that one. Can't wait to try that out. Safe to say, this cruise on the car could be real exciting when it comes to slip through the car floor. We see the e-bike getting into the shadow, but it seems our car didn't slow down and continued marching forward, so we took over for safety. Big curve here. We stepped in again to pull ourselves back from crashing in the upcoming lane. Manual takeover required, for reasons we did not know. Yeah, it's been hustling for 1 hour. Of course, it needs a coffee break. Now we're chilling behind the bus, but our company car seems a little rushy and took the head start. Now the bus is gone and the AVATR is still catching its breath, so we had to kick it. On two-way street like this, the cruise control wouldn't cross the full line for the overtake. But we're curious about FSD's choice in this scenario in China. Here comes the strangest jump out, where we should go straight as shown in the nav, but the cruise goes right. And it's easy to see that this whole system fails much more frequently in suburban areas than in the downtown and highways. From our point of view, there could be some inadequacy of such situational training. The last U-turn, hitting on its Achilles heel, manual required. Okay, big curve, manual takeover. And finally, the rendezvous, Tianshan Forest Park, a great spot for chilling or camping on weekends. And we're having a special local chicken meal. Comment below if you're interested. Now we have the checklist of HUAWEI Inside, so you can see what it's really like on the road. There were 13 jump outs in total, where 4 out of sharp turns, 1 out of roads under construction, and 1 to avoid the traffic head. And out of safety concerns, we stepped in 3 times, because if not slowing down, we're in someone cut in line, reckless lane changing on the ramp, and being excessively close to surrounding vehicles. It's also a reminder that it's never too careful to drive with cruise control. And there were 4 jump outs, that seemed irrelevant but still affected the whole experience. About the dynamic, we believe it does best on highways and worst on suburban roads, which doesn't quite match our expectations since it could be simpler crossing the countryside. It might get better with adequate amount of training. Even in the city, it's apt to have a more aggressive style for lane change. And with some inappropriate acceleration on ramps or curbs, the overall ride quality gets compromised. And it is surely incapable of getting through big turns, which let us wonder about the future FSD. We are truly impressed by how fast the cruise tech is evolving, given the progress we've seen during nearly the past 3 years. And we urge to see FSD coming in, by which technology might get even more quickly upgraded, leading us right into the new era when people could get fully liberated from daily commute drive. This is where to go. Stay tuned, and we'll see you soon.